necessarily reflect those of the staff or management of Radio Dihoris. The content broadcast on this show is meant for informational and entertainment purposes only.
Top of the morning, Bay, with Gling Bay.
Get to know about the traffic on your way and what's news around the world today.
Some wisdom skills along the way.
Oh, and a song to hum along with and sway.
Get your perfect entertaining start to the day.
At 9 a.m. every weekday morning with
Mahima's Good Morning Bay. गुड मॉर्निंग बे, आप सभी लोग हमें तब से एक प्यार भरा नमस्ते,
नमस्कार,
वनकम,
नमस्कार,
खुशामदीद,
सलाम अलैकुम,
सत श्री अकाल,
मेकांदर की वंदनम,
जय स्वामी नारायण,
जय श्री कृष्ण,
जय जनेन्द्र,
मैं भाई बदल को बोलते याली मदद,
मोलाली मदद बोलते हुए सारे फीजे मन लोग बोलेंगे नीसा बुला बनजन, हम आ गए हैं आपके प्यारे महिमा के द्वारे, मैं फालतू बाबा
And of course, myself, Faltu Rani, लेकर आपके लिए one more Good Morning Bay in a new era. Totally exciting and totally mastani.
I know, Faltu Rani, seriously, you know, as Trump walks out yesterday, I felt like, you know, oh my God, there goes, end of an era.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but then, yes, we all make mistakes. We also made a mistake 4 years ago. The good part about the whole thing is we get back in the election process where we can actually, you know, correct our ways, right?
Right.
That's always the case. It's a very good thing which we have right now here, thanks to democracy. Which was the whole element of it was threatened in the previous couple of weeks, actually. Mm-hmm. Now we have Joe Biden in the office. President Joe Biden is right now presiding over the White House thing and everything. So let's see what's happening. We'll definitely keep track of all these things. Not just because it's going to be him. We're going to go easy. No, we're going to be even more tougher right now because we don't want to do the same mistake what happened with this president. What's his name again?
I don't know. I don't want to talk about it.
Right. I know. People are the positive things. I don't even know. But of course, let me tell you, abhi aapko, we're going to give you some updates right now, what's happening with the news. Wo to aayega aapko Good Morning Bay pe. And along with that, we also will share with you what's happening with the local news as well. And also some international news for you guys to chew upon. If you want to catch up in detail about the news we share with you guys on air, you're welcome to go check it out on news blog, newsmediamahima.com, which is actually a consolidation of all the news which you guys share with you guys on air over here. And a full time to share much of the information, we will definitely go and get it to you guys and post links for you guys to go get details on that same blog, mediamahima.com. And now we can even this is your traffic update of what's happening on the roads today. Let's take a hal, total sastavi.
It's time for the Bandhu traffic update. Call us from wherever you are at 408-912-2479.
It might just be me reading, all the positive notes in the world attributed to the fact that we actually have somebody going back to Florida. But the point is there are no accidents reported today.
Mm-hmm.
People are a little bit less stressed out. I think whenever there's stress for Faltu Rani, I always see that there's a correlation to, a very positive correlation to stress. And stress and accidents on the road.
Yeah.
I'm talking about stress and not just individual stress, it's group stress.
Oh, really?
Yeah, do get stressed, Faltu Rani.
There's something called group stress.
Yeah, as in collective stress. We all have one singularity, right? I don't know if you remember this, Faltu Rani. We actually have singularity, I keep telling you, right?
Hmm.
The thing is, I think that we all, when our stress levels come together, it becomes totally stressed out.
Yeah.
Right now, Bajan, after yesterday, today, again a smooth day. No traffic incidents across the whole Bay Area.
Huh.
A little bit on this side, that side, but I mean, that's not a traffic. That's more of a warning for fog and everything at Delhi City now. So apart from that, I think there's a bit of road work happening in different places. Don't worry about those part of it. There's no accidents, though. That means people on the roads are a little more calm right now. They're not riled up. They don't actually feel that there's no... So it's a good thing for them. It's a part for us to start off today. The 21st, somebody sent me a WhatsApp forward saying that this is the 21st day of the 20th year of the 21st century. I wasn't like, oh. But good. That's fine. But so once in a millennium, I suppose.
Once in a millennium? Well, maybe. Yeah, obviously. Not once in a millennium. Once in a century. It should be 21st
century, no, Faltu Rani.
So next time it'll be 22nd day of the 20. Oh, no.
Exactly.
No, 22nd year No, it won't happen.
It won't happen. It'll only happen after a millennium.
Oh, God. Got me like completely. My mind is like going around in circles.
Oh, no. You're just feeling happy, Faltoni. Is that the dopamine rush you guys are feeling right now in your minds because you suddenly are relaxed?
Yeah.
No, I'm not kidding, Faltoni. Actually, good things happen. Now you're in the days of happiness, right?
Yeah.
Suddenly, it's like a sigh of relief.
Yeah.
But don't get distracted with that, Parnajan. They are politicians at the end of the day.
Right.
They believe, they live and breathe politics.
Right.
The reason why they're called ticks and politics.
Oh, God.
Yeah, it's politicking always, Parnajan. So don't, but of course, good thing is celebrate the small, small wins. That's what we did. And what's going to happen in Senate, we don't know because it's still 50-50 split up. The good things are going to happen or not, we don't know. But 17 executive orders already have been passed on. And I'll tell you one thing, but weather-wise, if you look at it outside, it's nice, bright and sunny. Enjoy it while it lasts because tomorrow is going to get cloudy and going to rain. Probably we'll have rainfall all through the weekend. If you plan to go some outdoor thing, Saturday morning is the best bet. Join the Mind Pragna if you want it. Apart from that, I think you guys better stay indoors only because of rain.
Right.
Because there's 80% chance of rain on Sunday and of course 70% chance of rain on Fridays tomorrow. Because right now there's going to be as bright as sunny outside. The clouds are going to come in by afternoon, I suppose, like late afternoon. And then all the way overcast all of Friday, actually. So it's a wonderful weather, wonderful day. We'll give you more updates on what's happening in the news right on. So let's directly jump into the headlines. Faltoni, what do you have in the headlines today?
Well, Altababa, there's a whole bunch of headlines that I have.
What's new about the Faltoni? You always have a whole bunch of headlines.
So one thing that I do want to start off with is to talk about yesterday's inaugural ceremony.
Mm-hmm.
How different it was for the women. Did you notice?
How different women? Yeah, women actually were wonderful. I love the plum color dress which, what's her name, Michelle Obama was sporting.
Exactly.
She looked awesome in that.
Exactly.
And there was also, I think, Kamala Harris' daughter.
Yeah.
Adopted daughter. She had a wonderful dress on.
Yeah. Emhoff, right?
Yeah. Wasn't that a nice dress?
That was beautiful. I love the house.
Sometimes I feel women are very bad that way.
Why?
At Trump's time, everybody wore white. And
what?
Now suddenly everything's colorful right now.
No, in this particular thing, what I really liked, people would have thought that, you know, what's her name? Melania Trump was a fashion icon and all that
stuff.
Right? But yesterday, one person that stood out, to stand out next to people like Michelle Obama, you know, with their towering personalities and the way they dress and everything, right? And Lady Gaga. It takes a lot. And this is Ella Emhoff. I thought she stood out yesterday, and even the news articles are talking about it, about her jacket, that whole houndstooth jacket. And she's actually, it's her own design apparently. So she's an artsy teen.
So what does that tell you? But that tells you that PR is always there.
Yeah.
Trying to make things very nice and relatable to people.
Yes.
And still that particular jacket would be so expensive, out of reach of 90% of Americans.
Yes.
See,
that's sparkles or it.
Exactly my point, Faltoni. You're like, you know, if they had worn something like from Walmart or someplace, I would have said, oh, wow, that's great.
Be quiet.
What ish? See, again, you don't miss the point. Again, it's like as they're princesses. You're treating them
not
like majesties.
They were all dressed.
They were dressed? Yeah, they all were dressed. So what?
They were dressed very nicely. So that's what I wanted to say.
Yeah,
my
because Trump time, they did not dress properly. They were dressed in white.
They did not dress properly. They dressed well.
They dressed in white.
That was to signify women's suffrage. That was a protest, remember?
You know, I'll tell you one thing, Bandajan. One particular hero of this particular whole thing, if at all, we all are taking a sigh of relief right now. I'm very happy. Okay, part of it, all the Democrats working very together. But one person you have to thank, Faltoni.
Huh.
And that person is the person who wears colorful masks in the
Nancy Pelosi?
Yes.
Oh my God, I love her mask collection, dude. Seriously.
Look at the mask collection, Faltoni. See, again, you're getting distracted.
Huh.
She was the person who started the whole thing.
Yeah.
Had she forgotten about it and crossed the party lines and done something about the nation, we still would have had Trump in the...
Be quiet!
What?
What do you mean she would have crossed party lines? What does that mean?
She stuck to her guns, right? She told. Father Day, remember, she was the first person to swear.
There were a few people.
Excuse me, swearing in ceremony. Hillary Clinton was not even in the which
Elizabeth Warren.
Okay.
These are all people who, and you know, you got to thank them anyway.
I think you should thank them. They are the people who actually cracked the ceiling. But right now, ladies, please watch out. Don't walk barefoot because the glass ceiling is broken and the glass pieces are there on the floor. Buy expensive shoes.
It's barely a crack, Altababa.
What?
The day that
a lady gets
elected as the president of the United States of America, that day the glass ceiling
is still the second most influential position in the world.
Yeah, we think so.
Oh my God. So that shows that you'll never be happy about things.
No,
It's okay. It's fine, Falguni. I understand.
I still think that America could have a woman woman president. I'm happy that there's a vice president. Yes, definitely. But I think that we were ready for a female president.
We were ready for it, I think, 2 elections ago.
Yes, exactly.
But unfortunately, again, the white man had to prevail.
Yeah.
Hey, again, I don't see. I sometimes feel like, you know, we just too much on these things. But Nijan, let's do one thing. Let's celebrate the small things right now. If you relax right now, wonderful. Keep it that way. Let's not stress out of all the stuff, right, Falguni? Yeah. What else do we have now that we don't have? I know suddenly the news becomes very pika because
No. There's a lot of good news. And there's a lot of work cut out for the Biden administration.
Excuse me, Falguni. I know there might be a lot of news. News will be there. You go look for something, you'll definitely find it. But I'm saying that all the explanatory stuff, all the fun things are lost.
What?
No longer do I enjoy watching Seth Meyers anymore. It's like, you know, there's nothing else for him right now. Now it's like, you know, the situation, like, you know, suddenly you're like taken away from all your content is lost.
Don't worry, Trump promised you, Altababa, that for people like you, he said, I'll be back in some form.
Hey, no, he's gone. See,
no, wait, okay. Can I get to the news, please?
Okay, fine.
Okay. President Joe Biden moved swiftly on his first full day in the White House on Thursday.
Unbelievable, 70-year-old man, he's moved swiftly?
Yes, to fight the COVID-19 pandemic, his top priority as he turns the page on 4 years of Donald Trump's tumultuous leadership. The Biden administration is aiming at a coordinated federal coronavirus response to the 10-month pandemic, focusing on boosting vaccines, increasing testing, reopening schools, and addressing inequalities thrown up by the disease. Trump frequently sought to play down the severity of the virus, which has killed more than 405 Americans as of today, left much of the pandemic planning to individual states, which has resulted in a patchwork of policies across the country. We can and will beat COVID-19. America deserves a response to the COVID-19 pandemic that is driven by science, data, and public health, not politics, the White House said in a statement outlining its strategy against the coronavirus. The virus has cast a shadow over Biden's inauguration on the steps of the U.S. Capitol on Wednesday. Crowds, which often reach into the hundreds of thousands for the swearing-in of a president, were kept away for fear of spreading infection.
See, I tell you, he came back. See, Trump came back.
In what way?
He will not forget about him. You just can't. And in fact, it doesn't make sense to take a jab at the president right now because we have, other than Trump, you know, a total blessing for us. So, I don't know. It's like, you know, suddenly the news becomes very pika.
U.S. President Joe Biden signed half a dozen executive orders, and this is not fika, Altababa, on Wednesday to reverse hardline immigration policies put in place by Donald Trump.
Okay, let me say it again, Falguni. See, even this
Although
news I did...
Although migration experts warn that it'll take months or longer to unravel many of the restrictions imposed in the past 4 years.
Wait, Falguni, again. This also news item written in Trump.
Yes,
you get what I'm saying? It's Trump did undo Trump.
Biden undid things of Trump. Because, see, what Trump did was like a typical dictator style. Came in and signed. He loved signing those executive orders and holding it up for camera. Remember? So Biden undid. So that's the good part about an executive order.
Biden's not doing which Trump did very well.
Which?
After he signed, he gave a sweet smile to the camera.
Oh, God.
He did. Did you see that? Have you seen his photographs? You see photographs where he signed things?
Oh, God.
He'll be like, I'm king. I signed. Yeah. Hey, but you know what, Falguni? I know that he actually put a stop, executive order to stop the building of the wall immediately.
Mm-hmm.
But I think they should dismantle the wall and put it around Mar-a-Lago.
I know they won't. Because the people of Mar-a-Lago want him out. He's not supposed to stay there, make that his residence, by the way.
What?
Did you know that?
He moved from there. Didn't he move his residence?
No. He's not supposed to be living there. He supposedly sold a portion of the property to development for resorts. And the deal that he struck with the local city and the local that surrounding area is the fact that he will not live there more than, I think, 15 days at a stretch.
Mm-hmm.
Or something like that. Anyway, in a sharp departure from his Republican predecessor, Biden, a Democrat, just hours after being sworn in, also sent an immigration bill to Congress that proposes opening a path to citizenship for millions of immigrants living in the States unlawfully. The executive actions signed at a ceremony at the White House included immediately lifting a travel ban on 13 mostly Muslim-majority and African countries, halting construction of the U.S.-Mexico border wall and reversing a Trump order preventing migrants who are in the United States illegally from being counted for congressional districts. Biden signed a memorandum directing the Department of Homeland Security and the U.S. Attorney General to preserve the DACA program, which President Obama had put in place, and which protects migrants who come to the country as children from deportation, and reversed Trump's executive order calling for stricter immigration enforcement away from the country's international borders. Biden's DHS also issued a memorandum calling for a 100-day moratorium on some deportations. So DHS also said that they would end all enrollments in a controversial Trump program known as the Migrant Protection Protocols that forced more than 65,000 asylum seekers back to Mexico to wait for their U.S. court hearings. Mm-hmm. The release did not clarify what will happen to migrants who are currently in the program, many of whom have been stuck for months in squalid tent camps near the southwest border. So if you want to catch up on more on this particular story and the comprehensive immigration reform bill that President Biden, President Biden has introduced for Congress and the Senate to pass, then you can go to MediaMahima.com. Another key thing that he did, Banujan, was his move to scrap the Keystone XL oil pipeline, while a blow to Canada's energy sector is a blessing in disguise for Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, who's eager to embrace the new administration, two sources familiar with the matter have said. Biden formally revoked the permit to build the pipeline on Wednesday, killing the $8 billion project to pump oil sands crude from Alberta to Nebraska. At first glance, it's bad news, but at least now the matter is settled and be souring bilateral relations for months to come, a diplomatic source from a major allied country said. Canada hasn't had to expand any serious political capital with the Biden administration on the pipeline and can now focus on many other areas where Trudeau feels the two nations should be cooperating.
But of course, Benjan, I think one more good news is the fact that we're going to be going back into the World Health Organization, part of it, the U.S. part of it, for
yes.
Sure. And probably more help about the vaccine going to come out. Because, hey, by the way, the vaccination, you know, there was a news about Southern California. There was Moderna. People who took Moderna, one dose was supposed to be
one particular batch, right?
One particular batch was defective is what they said. Actually, it's not defective. Actually, they held it back because I think around 10 people or so actually had some reactions to it. Good news is the fact that they've cleared the batch and it's going to be reinstituted. Not going to be, at least on 3 lakh people are going to be getting the vaccines again. The reason for the particular 10 people had issues was found to be scientifically issue with a needle which was not produced properly. The administering needle which they actually do it. So that's what they've changed. And that's good news right now. And also one more good news for people who are actually taking the vaccine. The vaccines are supposedly effective against the new variants of COVID-19.
Oh.
That's good news, right?
That's great news.
And of course, it's opening up, Banujan. Just hang in there. It's opening up. As we get to the community immunity, it's going to be good. In terms of numbers, what's happening over here, statewide, of course, unfortunately, we had a lot of deaths of COVID the past 2 days. Almost 700 new deaths as of yesterday from statewide, Banujan. And the positive cases coming up, of course, we have touched 3.01 actually. It's like around 3,019,000 cases statewide. In county, in our county, Santa Clara County alone, we've had around 700 to 800 new cases and around 33 deaths in the past 2 days. But anyway, Vijay, let's all hope for the best. And then stay sheltered. Physical distancing, very important. Mask up, wash your hands, and sanitize your hands if possible. Use a hand sanitizer. Live healthy, eat healthy, incorporate a healthy lifestyle, exercise and everything, Banujan.
Correct. And, but you know what, Alto Baba, the CDC's new leader, Dr. Rochelle Walensky, is saying that it's positive. She says that healthier days lie ahead. So even though...
Fauci said that.
Yeah, that they're saying that even though they're predicting also about 100,000 more fatalities that will be reported by mid-February, apparently. So, let's tell you something else that's happening with regard to what President Joe Biden has done. President Joe Biden will sign 10 executive orders on Thursday to fight the coronavirus pandemic, that is today, including directing that disaster funds be used to help reopen schools and requiring that people wear masks on planes and buses, officials have said. Biden, a Democrat who took over from Republican President Donald Trump on Wednesday, has promised a fierce fight against the pandemic that has killed over 405,000 in the United States under Trump's watch. In one order will require mask wearing in airports and on certain modes of public transportation, which includes trains, airplanes and intercity buses. He also plans to sign orders on Thursday to establish a COVID-19 testing board to ramp up testing, address supply shortfalls, establish protocols for international travelers and direct resources for minority communities that are hit hard by the infectious disease. He plans to also direct FEMA to reimburse states and Native American tribes fully for the costs associated with the National Guard and emergency supply effort to combat the virus. Biden's measures also restore full reimbursement from the FEMA Disaster Relief Fund for costs related to reopening schools.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. This is amazing. I hope all these executive orders that are going to come into place going to be put by local districts and local governments as well, you know, because a lot of it, funds are being allocated out of but it's completely up to the local school districts and the local counties to decide what they want to do, right? So
mm-hmm.
far. Yeah. But like you said, Altu, ever since Trump is gone, there's been something that's going on.
What's going on?
No plan, no queue, nothing. QAnon followers are now reeling as Biden gets inaugurated.
Oh my God.
For 3 years, adherents of the sprawling QAnon conspiracy theory awaited a so-called Great Awakening, scouring anonymous web postings for a shadowy Q figure and passing statements by former President Donald Trump, whom they believe their champion. On Wednesday, they grappled with a harsh reality check. He had left office with no mass arrests or other victories against the supposed cabal of Satan-worshipping pedophile cannibal elites, especially the Democrats he was ostensibly fighting. Instead, Democrat Joe Biden was calmly sworn into office, leaving legions of QAnon faithfuls struggling to make sense had transpired.
Oh my God, not fair at all. See, seriously, leaving them in a lurch right now.
Yeah. Sam, in especially one Telegram channel apparently, which had more than 18,400 QAnon members,
mm-hmm.
they were split between those still urging to try plan and those saying that they felt betrayed. It's obvious now we've been had. No plan, no Q. Nothing, wrote one user. So this is going on in those channels as well, Banujan. And if you want to catch up on more news stories that we have for you today, Banujan, you can go to MediaMahima.com. Wall Street is doing really well. And of course, Facebook is coming under a lot of scrutiny, especially with their regard to their WhatsApp privacy policy. And yesterday we talked about how the government to stay the farm laws for 18 months, right? Numbers have rejected the government's proposal to stay these laws, and they're saying that they won't settle for anything but a complete repeal of these laws. More on that too, you will find out from MediaMahima.com. India is also going to begin commercial exports of the AstraZeneca vaccine starting tomorrow. So more on all that on MediaMahima.com. That's all we have time for on this morning's Good Morning Bay. We'll be back tonight live at 5 on the Pam Pam Show. Till then, have yourselves a terrific, wonderful Thursday. Stay safe, stay happy, stay healthy.